I've spent the last 30 plus years of my life working on artificial intelligence in various forms and applying AI in various vertical markets and working toward artificial general intelligence as sort of the grand goal of the AI field. And there's a lot of different issues that come up when you're trying to build an AI system. But one of the key issues is sort of governance of the AI system, like who owns that AI system, who controls that AI system. This question is what led me ultimately to co-found SingularityNet. It seemed like the way the world was going was, AI started with a few large national militaries providing all the AI funding. Now it had shifted to, a half dozen to a dozen huge multinational corporations controlling all the AI. It's like that's not how things should be. That's not what's for the greatest benefit of humanity. We want the control and the governance of the global AI network as it comes to dominate more and more of the global economy and move toward general intelligence. We want this to be democratically controlled, and you want it to be decentralized so it's not easy for any party to take over and use for their own narrow ends. And blockchain is the right tool for that. I mean, just like Bitcoin and Ethereum are sort of decentralized money, and smart contracts allow, decentralized software networks to run on a decentralized global computer. AI can run on that same sort of framework where you have a blockchain-based decentralized infrastructure for AI. So you have a global AI system with pieces running in a lot of different places. And we launched SingularityNet platform on the Ethereum blockchain because it was kind of the only way to do it at that point in time in late 2017, right? I mean, Ethereum were the first to deploy a smart contract platform that was reasonably easy to use, right? We knew at the time, 2017, when we started SingularityNet, that Ethereum was too slow and too expensive to really serve as the infrastructure of an intelligent global brain. Ethereum has evolved a lot. There's more technical sophistication underlying it than there was in 2017. But the bottom line is it's slower and a lot more expensive than it was in 2017, right? Like that, from a practical usage perspective, it hasn't gotten better. The use of Ethereum constrains what we can do with SingularityNet. When I have to give a demo of our platform, the most annoying part is waiting for the Ethereum transaction to start off the interaction with the platform, which is ridiculous, right? And I mean, and if you're looking in DeFi space, I mean, you could pay 100K of gas for a relatively moderate-sized transaction if you want it done rapidly. It's insane, right? So when I looked at all the blockchain projects out there, Cardano, that's really a very profoundly beautiful and well-designed code base. They use the Haskell programming language, which I've been a big fan of since 1993 or something, well before Haskell became popular. And they've taken the trouble to do formal proofs of correctness of their Ouroboros, like the core consensus algorithms. So they've really taken a very rigorous and well-structured approach where the code is beautifully architected. The core algorithms are formally mathematically proved to do what they're supposed to do. And I'm a math PhD originally. I put a lot of stock on that. And I feel like the thought they put into the design in terms of modularizing the design and layering it in multiple layers of abstraction, I think this will allow them to, meet the needs of the future of the blockchain world. And of course, the future of the blockchain world is, in a way, the future of the whole computer software world, because I think all software is going to need to be decentralized, and software is eating everything. So, in a way, that's the future of the whole world, right? So, if you look at it that way, you want a really solid blockchain infrastructure, because this is going to be part of the guts of the entire global economy and part of the guts of the AGI minds that are going to exceed human intelligence one day. Cardano was the only blockchain project I saw that seemed to have any prayer of having the sort of depth of thought and level of code quality you would need to really be future capable in that sense.